The other day I promised, you know, I will spend some time with you to show the difference between simple past and the present perfect. The name itself, you can see, present perfect. Completed in the present. The other is past. So I think that distinction is clear. Present perfect. Perfect means completed. Action is completed in the present moment. The other is past. See, if you ask questions, did you and have you, then you can easily understand that. Let me ask you a question like this. Did you go to school yesterday? Did you go to school yesterday? So that is question. Have you gone to school? Have you gone to school today? So that is the difference. Very clear difference, I think. Did you go to school yesterday? You cannot ask, have you gone to school yesterday? See that? Can you ask questions like this? Did you go to school today? And have you gone to school yesterday? Is it possible? No. That's not possible. You can understand that something is irritating you. Some problem in your mind. Did you go to school today? Have you gone to school today? Yesterday? Can you say? No. Because, have you gone to school present perfect, completed today? The other is, did you go to school, that is yesterday. So what does that mean? That means, if a time is a signaling where that tells you past, so prior to speaking, you have to use the simple past. If your action has some connection with the present, you cannot use the simple past. You have to use the present perfect to show that the action is complete. Isn't it? So that is it. Did you go? Did you and have you? If you compare this thing. See, I'll ask you another question. Did you eat your breakfast? Did you eat your breakfast? That means, did you eat your breakfast? Anytime, see, this is my moment of speaking. So prior to my speaking, anytime, that is the thing. See, prior to my speaking. So that is here, this side. Anytime here, that is prior. Did you eat your breakfast? There is no, the question is not sharp. Isn't it? Did you eat your breakfast? Most probably it is sometime, say yesterday. Or not today, did you eat it? Today you cannot say, did you ask, did you? You can say that, say, by 4 o'clock or so. Isn't it? So then is the day. But on the other hand, have you eaten? Have you eaten? So it has got relevance to the present. Have you eaten your breakfast? Have you taken your breakfast? That means, whether you have completed it just now, whether you completed in the present time, that's the point. On the other hand, did you eat your breakfast? It's now a sharpness against it. Isn't it? Okay, let's say. Did he do that work? Did he do that work? Or did you? So that's better now. Did you do that work? He said. Have you done it? Have you done that work? So what is the meaning? What do you understand? Again, think of, say, See, there is the difference you can say. Did you do that verb? Anytime prior to my speaking. But if you say, have you done that verb? Present. So this got a present effect. I think you will agree with me. Isn't it? That's what it is. If you have got a time, the time of the past is indicated, like yesterday, last night, and so on. You cannot use the present perfect. You can only use the simple past. Now you see, another thing. Let's say, once upon a time, there lived a king, famous sentence. Once upon a time, there has lived a king. See, compare these sentences. Once upon a time, there lived a king. Years ago. How can you say, once upon a time, there has lived a king? See the difference? This is a horrible violence committed to the tense, that is, the present perfect tense. Isn't it? Violating all principles. How can you say, once upon a time, there has lived a king? Once upon a time is far, far away. Then how can it has a present context? It has a present meaning, no? It's impossible. So you have to say, once upon a time, there lived a king, and you can say, a king has lived here. A king has lived here. That is, the moment of speaking, it is over. A king has lived here. He is not here now. A king has lived here. Clear? Alright, let's see. One more example. You say like this. I went to Somalia. I have gone to Somalia. Recently. So what does that mean? I went to Somalia last year. So now we can say again clear. Means this happened last year. What about this one? I have gone to Somalia recently. The meaning of present is there. Present perfect. Recently. Means my going is over. But it has got the sharpness. It's very sharp. Means the action is perfect, say by the time of my speaking. The other one is, I went to Somalia last year. There's no relevance to your present life. Understand? There's no relevance to what has happened to you. Or yes, you are going to Somalia, it has no relevance here with the present, but here it has. That is, very often you get corrections like this, to correct sentences in this way. So, correct the following sentences. What is the mistake? Also you have to explain what is the mistake. You say like this, we were in America last year. We were in America. Sorry, like that will be a correction. We have been in America last year. So you have to correct the sentence. How can you say last year? Because there is no present context at all. So you cannot say, we have been in America last year. You have to correct it as, we have been in America recently. Or we have been in America. Or we have been in America since some time again. some time in the past. You cannot say, we have been in America last year. If you want to say, we are, to say this correctly in this way, we were, you have to say, we were in America last year. Is that clear? So, the point to remember is that, just that the name of the tense, one is past tense, simple past, no aspect. That's another point to remember. There's no aspect, no aspect of progressive, no aspect of perfect, complete. No aspect of completion, no aspect of progressive. That is, we were in America. We have been in America, that means it has some relevance to your present situation. Relevance to the present situation. Because the mean that the tense, the name of the tense itself is like this one. Simple past and present perfect. There is an aspect there. That is, the action is complete at the moment of speaking or by the moment of speaking. Understand? In the evening, the warden in your hostel asked you, did you play football? Did you play football? There is no specific time mentioned. Did you play sometime in the past? Can be yesterday, or it can be day before yesterday, or it can be last week. Did you play football? Have you played football? That is, it has got some present effect. Have you played football? That means he is asking this question at 5 in the evening. 4 to 5 is your outdoor game, time for outdoor, compulsory games. Then he says, you are coming, have you played football? Somebody is sitting somewhere and says, have you played football? So that means, have you completed playing football now? Did you play football? It can be any time in the past, any time prior to speaking. So these things, if you keep in your mind, see, first you remember the difference in name. One is simple past, the other is present perfect. Present perfect, perfect means action completed, complete. I think now you have understood what I was trying to tell you. Tomorrow we will do an exercise based on this. Then definitely you will understand it much better, I think. So for the time being, bye. You can also play this game in the class. Did you? Have you? Understand? Did you? Have you? Did you sleep well last night? Can you say, have you slept well last night? No. That's not possible. A student is sleeping in the class. Suddenly he gets up. Then you can say, have you slept without any disturbance? That you can say. That means at the time of speaking. You cannot say, did you sleep? Did you sleep? That's something that is not possible at that time to ask. Have you slept? Because it has a present effect. And the question has, it is sharp. I think it is clear, I have tried to explain to you. You have understood this. Tomorrow we will do an exercise based on this. Till then, bye. Have a nice day. Enjoy your life.